Hey, what's going on, everybody? This is Tyrone back with Tech Life. And in this video, we have another network update for you guys from Verizon. This time, it's coverage improvements. So yesterday's video, if you watched it, it was a coverage expansion. But Verizon is also going through segments now, or cities and towns, I should say, where they are improving its cell coverage, speeds, capacity, densification. That also has to happen in a lot of areas, especially to make their C-band more contiguous, continuous in coverage and better indoor penetration. So Wilton picks Verizon as a potential cell tower partner. So this is going to be a monopole setting behind a middle school. They just want to offer better cell coverage in that area. Likely before, they were able to have cell coverage at that school or in that area in particular, but it wasn't great. There was likely cell edge service. Speeds weren't that great. So now Verizon would like to put a cell tower there. And this also can tie in with the process the carriers have to go through to even get a cell site approved. So just to kind of read a part of the article off, just a brief paragraph. The town has agreed to partner with Verizon to potentially erect a monopole cell tower behind the parking lot of the bus depot on School Road near the Middlebrook Middle School. So like I said, it's behind the middle school. They want to put the site. So according to First Select woman Lynn Vanderslice on Monday, she and the tower planner Michael Ritten will have to present the full lease agreement to the board of selectmen for approval. So again, there's steps to get this approval. So the tower planner has to get with somebody from the town. Then they have to agree to it. Then they have to present to the board of approval, and then the next board of selectmen meeting is set for October 4th. So they are on somebody else's time. So there's always a middleman to get this approval. And then they still don't know if the board is even going to agree to put the cell tower there. That's another step. What if they disapprove? Then who do they go through to get it potentially approved? Is that it? You know, if the board does not approve it, is that already it? They can't do anything else. So if the town does approve, per the lease agreement, they would get $30,000 annually on an increase of 2.75% annually per the agreement. So let me know what you think about this. I will leave the article in the description down below. Maybe you are from this part in Connecticut and have been there and know that the service is not that great there. And if you have been, let us know in the comment section down below. If you are new to the channel or you have been on the channel and you have not yet liked, shared, subscribed, make sure you do so. Hit that notification bell so you are notified when I do upload content. Make sure to follow my social media outlets for more updates and interactions. Thanks again for watching. This is Tyrone with Tech Life. I will see you in the next one. Peace.